If you loved Knight Rider, you know that light. KITT's iconic scanner bar sweeping back and forth like a heartbeat. Hey guys, in this video I'll show you how to build your own Knight Rider style LED chaser using a 555 timer and a CD4017 counter. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 20 jumper wires, a 470 ohm resistor, a 1 kilo ohm resistor, a 47 kilo ohm resistor, 61N4148 fast switching diodes, 6 red LEDs, 1 9 volt battery, 1 9 volt battery buckle connector, 1 555 timer IC, 1 CD4017 decade counter, a 1 microfarad capacitor, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the top left is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and a stable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, a stable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 47 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 47 kilo ohm resistor into pin 2 or trigger in pin 7 or discharge. Bend the ends of a 1 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 1 kilo ohm resistor into pin 7 or discharge in pin 8 or VCC. Insert a 1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. Insert the anode in pin 2. Insert a CD4017 decade counter in the middle of the breadboard. Insert it a few rows below the 555 timer. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 of the CD4017. Insert a jumper wire into pin 16. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 and pin 15. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 and pin 13. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 of the 555 and pin 14 of the CD4017. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 and a few rows below the CD 4017. This is the path to the first red LED. Insert a 1N4148 fast switching diode in the same row as the jumper wire. The anode is facing the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. The cathode is in the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 2 and a few rows below the first diode. This is the path to the second red LED. Insert a diode in the same row as the jumper wire. The anode is facing the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. The cathode is in the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 11 in the same row as the second diode. This is the path of the LED moving in reverse direction. Insert a jumper wire into pin 4 and a few rows below the second diode. This is the path to the third red LED. Insert a diode in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 9 in the same row as the third diode. Insert a jumper wire into pin 7 and a few rows below the third diode. Insert a diode in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 6 in the same row as the fourth diode. Insert a jumper wire into pin 5 and a few rows below the fourth diode. Insert a diode in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 10 in the same row as the fifth diode. Insert a jumper wire into pin 1 and a few rows below the fifth diode. Insert a diode in the same row as the jumper wire. Insert a red LED in the same row as the diode and the negative rail. Insert a 470 ohm resistor into the negative rail in the middle of the breadboard. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the resistor and the negative rail. Connect the 9-volt battery buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. If KITT looked at this circuit, it would respond, "Michael, my scanners are fully operational." Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This circuit creates the classic Knight Rider ping pong sweep by using a 555 timer as a clock, a CD4017 decade counter to step through positions, and a small diode matrix to mirror those steps so the light appears to travel back and forth. The 555 is wired as an unstable oscillator. Pin 2 and pin 6 are tied together into a 1 microfarad capacitor to ground. Pin 7 sits between a 1 kilo ohm resistor to 9 volt battery and a 47 kilo ohm resistor down to pin 2 and pin 6. Pin 4 is tied to pin 8 so the 555 runs continuously, while pin 3 serves as the clock output. Those pulses feed the CD4017's clock on pin 14. With pin 15 and pin 13 held low, the 4017 advances one active output per pulse. Q0 to Q9 and back to Q0. The very first output, Q0 or pin 3, drives the outer LED group by itself. The next group in is shared by Q1 or pin 2 and Q9 or pin 11, which are tied together through a single 1N4148 diode. Moving further inward, Q2 or pin 4 and Q8 or pin 9 share the next diode. The following group is driven by Q3 or pin 7 and Q7 and pin 6 through another shared diode. The next group is powered by Q4 or pin 10 and Q6 or pin 5 through another shared diode. The final group is driven solely by Q5 or pin 1 through its own diode. This arrangement means that as the 4017 counts from 0 up to 9, the LEDs light in a sequence. After that, the sequence reverses, giving the effect of the light traveling backwards. Thanks to the diodes isolating the outputs, the groups can share current paths without interfering with one another, producing the smooth back and forth chasing effect. I hope this video has shown you how to make an LED chaser with a 555 timer and CD4017 decade counter. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.